Good morning, everybody. My name is Karina Arquera, and the title of this poster is Indicators of Body Fat Mobilization of Lactating Beef Cows Under Short Nutritional Challenges. In extensive sucker cows farms, large variation in the quantity or quality of available food can be observed at different stages of the production cycle, and cows need to adapt to this change. So, the aim of this study was to investigate the metabolic adaptation of lactating beef cows to short periods of undernutrition and assess the accuracy of different indicators of fat mobilization. Materials and methods. We used 16 parda de montaña adult sucker cows. The animals were under 4 days energy restriction in months 2 and 3 postcardium. Each month had 3 periods, basal, challenge, and refeeding. During basal and refeeding, the diet met 100% of the energy requirements with hay and concentrate. And during the challenge, the diet met 55% of the energy requirements only with hay. Measurements. External measurements of fatness, such as body conditional score and subcutaneous fat, measured by ultrasonography on different body areas, the back fat thickness, the PA round side, and the 13th thoracic vertebra. Metabolized. Plasma was collected for the analysis of beta-hydroxybutyrate and non-esterified fatty acids, NEFA, resulting from the fat lipolysis, and malondialdehyde as product of the lipid peroxidation. Data were analyzed using a mixed linear model with month, period, and their interaction as fixed effect and co as the random effect. Results. Regarding the external measure of fatness, all results indicate that neither body conditional score nor back fat thickness were affected by month or phase. However, fat thickness measured at P8 and 13 thoracic vertebra decreased significantly for month 2 to 3, and P8 also decreased from the basal to the refeeding phase. Concerning to the plasma metabolites related to the fat mobilization, we found an interaction between month and phase. The response of these metabolites to the diet change was immediate in month 2, but in month 3, the difference among phase was less intense in NEFA and malondialdehyde and tended to be inexistent for beta-hydroxybutyrate. Conclusions. We can conclude that external measurements of fat thickness except for P8 only reflects changes in long term. On the other hand, the plasma metabolites, in particular non-esterified fatty acids and beta-hydroxybutyrate, are good indicators of lipid mobilization under a negative energy balance in the short term, especially in early lactation of sucker cows. Thank you very much.